In today's episode, Suzanne asks, how do you get Google Analytics to show you the name of the PDF being clicked on? This is a follow-up question to my February 20th, 2019 video on tracking PDFs as goals in Google Analytics. So if you want to go back into the archives, you can go to the blog post that goes with this. We'll have a link to that old episode. The short answer is to track PDFs as like any other page on your website, we have to create a page view because a PDF contains no HTML, therefore you can't put a Google Analytics tag in it, but we can track the click to it. So in Google Tag Manager, the way they do this is with a built-in click URL variable and a virtual page view. So let's swap over here. What we're going to do is you're going to open up your Google Tag Manager. The first thing we need to do is make sure that we're tracking click URLs. That's one of the many, many, many built-in variables. So go to Variables, click on Configure for Built-ins, and scroll down until you get to the click section. Personally, I like to make sure that all these are clicked, just as a general best practice. But at the very least, you want to absolutely make sure that click URL is turned on. All right, and for good measure, by the way, you should always have your Google Analytics set in here as a variable as well, just to make sure that you're not mistyping the ID number later on. Next, you're going to need a trigger. The trigger for a PDF should be the trigger type is just links. Click just links, right? Like so. And we want the click URL, which is what we just selected in variables, to match the regular expression, ignoring case, of /.pdf. Now, what this is doing is it's saying that we want to find any URL that has the .pdf extension. We escape the period because we're using a regular expression, which is a type of code that allows you to match multiple variations. And the reason we're choosing this instead of contains is that if you've got a bigger website, sometimes people will name files like a capital .pdf at the end, or you know, or capitalize just the P, or whatever the case is. People do some strange things on larger websites. And as a result, you would use this to track it. Now, if you are confident, because it's your website, maybe it's a smaller site, that no one ever does that, then you could just use contains, remove that backslash, and contains.pdf. So we're tracking any URL that contains that .pdf. This is a trigger, essentially saying, Google Tag Manager, listen for this and raise your hand when this happens. I'm going to, because my website's a little older and sometimes I do weird things, I'm going to leave it as the match regular expression. Okay, so now we've got a variable that is going to store a URL in its entirety when it's when it has that click URL, whatever the click is. And we've got a trigger that says, I want to run this only on things that, on URLs that contain .pdf. So the last thing we need to do now is set up that tag in order to send the actual information to Google Analytics. We have not done that yet. We're going to create a new tag. Let's call this something intelligible. Google Analytics PDF virtual page view. Our tag configuration, we're going to be using the Google Analytics Universal Analytics here. We're going to be doing a settings variable here. Make sure we have our, that's my tag there. We're going to make sure we have a page view set up because that's what we're sending. And then we're going to go down here to advanced settings, right? And in advanced settings, enable overrides. There we are. And we're going to do a field to set. We're going to override our normal variable. And we're going to choose, in this case, the built-in Google Analytics variable page, right? That is the page URL that Google Analytics is looking for. And in this case, we are going to use that click URL variable, right? So now we've got our click URL. We're sending it as a page here. And what the trigger we're going to choose is, of course, the PDF click. So now what we've done is we're saying Google Analytics, we're overriding the normal settings. And we're saying, hey, this link click that we're sending, that we know a user clicked on, is actually a page view, right? A treat it the same as though that PDF was a page on the website and track it as such. So we're essentially sending in some ways, it's not falsified data, but it's not real in the sense that there's no Google Analytics tag running on that PDF page. I'm going to hit save here. What this is going to do is it will now create page views in our Google Analytics tracking. Oh, always remember to hit submit. It will create page views in Google Analytics with those that full URL, including the PDF itself. So to Suzanne's question, that will show you the name of the PDF in your analytics. Now, that means it'll show up in your behavior section on what content on your site has gotten the most page views, because each of these PDFs will show up as a page in those page views. You can see which is the most popular PDF. This does not set a PDF as a goal, right? That's go back to the February 20th video for that. But this does set it as a page view. And probably a pretty good idea to have this implemented on your website if you've got a lot of PDFs. The steps we just took, by the way, apply to any file type. So if I go back to my workspace here, we have a PDF click with that regex. If you've got an MP3, let's say you have a podcast and you want to track links to podcast episodes, make an MP3 click URL and repeat the exact same process. If you've got video files for some strange reason stored on your website, if you have code samples, if you've got JSON or PHP or R code that you want to see people downloading it, you do the exact same thing. So you can track multiple different types of files on your website with this technique. So that's how you do it. It's very straightforward. It's not obvious, like it's not written down in the manual anywhere, but it is a pretty straightforward process once you implement it. So that's the process. Good question. Tag Manager, Google Tag Manager, is one of the most powerful and underused and underrated tools, I would say, in the entire Google marketing platform. We spend so much time on Google Analytics, rightly so, because that's where the outputs come to make decisions. But what you can do with Tag Manager is fascinating. So if you have some time, you know, when it's quiet or you have a few moments, spend some time in Tag Manager. Spend a lot of time in Tag Manager. Learn its capabilities, because it's pretty darn cool. As always, please leave questions in the questions box below. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and the newsletter. I'll talk to you soon. Take care. Want help solving your company's data analytics and digital marketing problems? Visit trustinsights.ai today and let us know how we can help you.